As nighttime falls here in Gwangju, Korea, it's the end of day 7 of the 28th World University Games. On the schedule in today's highlights, shooting wraps up its competition here in Gwangju. Football semifinals, Japan taking on France in a penalty shootout. In baseball, semifinal action between Japan and the United States. We'll look at handball, a matchup between Serbia and Montenegro. In athletics, the men's and women's 200 meter finals take place. In swimming, we'll look at a few sprints taking place in the pool tonight. And also women's team table tennis, the gold medal match. The final day of shooting competition at the Nanju Jilinamdo shooting range here in Gwangju. We'll start with the men's 10 meter air pistol final. There you see the start list. Few of the competitors featured here. There you see Jung Halim of Korea. He won gold in both the team 50 meter and team 10 meter air pistol competition earlier on. Zhang Jiwei of China, he has won 2 silver and 1 bronze medal so far here. He's also a former Olympic medalist. Florian Fouquet of France, he won the gold in the 25-meter standard pistol team competition. And also Park Dae-hoon of Korea, he won the gold in the 50-meter pistol. So lots of medalists represented here. There you get a look at Jung Halim's scoreboard. He will finish in third place and win the bronze medal. The two finalists are Zhang Jiwei and Deaku Engtaivan of Mongolia. Engtaivan won a silver in the 10-meter team air pistol and a bronze in the 50-meter team competition. And there you see him, and this time it is gold. Mongolia wins a gold medal in the 10-meter air pistol. Wang Jiwei of China is second, and Jung Halim of Korea wins the bronze. Now to the men's 50-meter rifle three positions final. And there are the competitors. Again, many medalists so far from Universiade represented here. And they would include Zhao Zhonghao of China, gold from the team rifle three positions. Yang Haoran of China. He is part of 2 world record holding teams in the 50 meter rifle three position and the 10 meter air rifle. Also Alexis Reynaud of France, he won gold in the 50 meter rifle prone team competition and a silver in the team rifle three positions. A hot day here in Gwangju. You see the fans even inside here trying to fan themselves off. And there is a look at Yang Haoran. Next to him is Kirill Grigoryan of Russia. He already has 2 medals to his credit as well. And there is Reynaud of France. He would finish third, scoring 443.6. So it's down to Yang and Grigoryan. And it will be Yang who wins a gold medal. His third of these games. Kirill Grigoryan will win the silver, and as mentioned, Reynaud the bronze. Now the men's double trap gold medal match. This features Andrea Vescovi of Italy and Artem Nekrasov of Russia. Vescovi won gold in the team competition, while Nekrasov won silver, falling to Italy in that event. Nekrasov also has a gold from the team double trap competition at Universiade in Kazan in 2013. This event dominated by the Italians. Two more Italians in the bronze medal match. That was won by Alessandro Chianese as he defeated Ignazio Tronca 28-24. And there you see Vescovi hitting that target. Nekrasov misses one there. And that opens the door for Vescovi. And he blows right through it. Gold medal for Italy's Andrea Vescovi, his second of the games, as he defeats Nekrasov 30-29. A great match here to wrap up shooting competition at Guangzhou. And there you see the three medalists. The second women's semifinal in football from the Nadju Public Stadium. France taking on Japan. Japan beat China 3-1 on penalties after a 0-0 score in regulation in their quarterfinal, while France beat Korea 2-0. Early on here in the first half, here's French captain Léa Rubio. Nice shot from distance there, but tipped over the bar by goalkeeper Nene Inoue. Nice stop. Now France again, late here now in the first half. Laura Bourgoin weaves her way through the Japanese side, but cannot beat Inoue. And that is how the first half will wrap up, 0-0. Eight minutes into the second half. Free kick there by Rubio. And it'll be headed home by Laura Agar. And France is up 1-0. You can see off that set piece, Japan heads it away, but they cannot defend Agar. And there you see that perfect header by her into the open net. Now for Japan, here is Anna Yamamori, and she'll fire that one with the left boot over top of the bar. That moments after the French goal. Now off the corner, off the bar initially, stays out, but Mana Miyashi will tip it home, and we are tied at one. And there you see that one off the bar twice. And then Miyashi able to knock it in. And after injury time here in the second half, we are done, tied at one. Heading now to a penalty shootout. As mentioned, Japan beat China already in their quarterfinal in a penalty shootout. There's Sissoko, she will score for Japan. Now that's Le Bien for France. Next up, this is Kaga, and she is stopped by the French keeper, Amandine Guérin. Now this is Laveau, and she'll just shoot that one wide. So the opportunity there for France to take the lead, and it's missed. Now back to France, Bourgoin off both posts. We already saw that for Japan off the corner, now here in the penalty shootout. Unbelievable here in the shootout for France. And there's a stop. That's Guérin again, stopping Hayashi. Now France, their captain Rubio, chance to win it, and she does, buries it home. And France off to the gold medal match. They will take on Russia for gold, while Japan will face Canada to win bronze. Baseball makes its return to Universiade. It's only been held twice, in 1993 in Buffalo and 1995 in Fukuoka. You're looking at the Guangzhou Kia Champions Field for this semifinal between the United States and Japan. First inning, runner on first. Igori Moji of Japan, he'll triple to the gap. That will score one, and Japan is on the board. Japan is 3-0 in the round robin, outscoring their opponents 27-0. We get a replay of that triple hit deep to the gap in right center field. Japan off to a good start. Now in the third inning, there's a pickoff attempt by Connor Seabold, but it ends up beyond Timothy Richards, and that'll advance the runner to third. And here you'll see a replay of that errant throw, and that allows Shibata to move up to third base. Still notes here in the third inning. And there's Yoshida with the sac fly. And that will score Shibata from third. 2-0 Japan. Now in the fifth inning, nobody out. A little roller up in front of home plate. And that one gets thrown away as well. A bit of a mix up there between catcher Chris Hudgens and pitcher John Gavin. Ball ends up in right field, and Yoshida gets all the way to third base. There's that little chopper right in front of the plate, and hesitation from both Hudgens and Gavin. And there you see Yoshida making the turn. And he heads all the way to third base. One out still in the fifth, 4-0 Japan. There's Yada with a base hit, and that'll score one more. There you see that base hit, hit into right field, and Japan starting to stretch its lead. Move now to the sixth inning, 5-0. High, deep fly ball to right field off the bat of Moji. And that sacrifice will score another 6-0 for the Japanese. Now to the seventh, two on, nobody out. Ground ball to first base, and another one will come home for Japan. That is Fujioka with that run. Still in the seventh. One out, and in this case here, Yada is going to get caught in a little bit of a rundown. And that'll be the second out of the inning. Now Usami, another one deep to the gap in right center field off the wall. He'll end up at third base, and another run in for Japan. A two-out triple. Japan now up 8-0. There you see it take a funny hop off the wall. That enabled the triple. Now the U.S. down to its final outs. Bravo will ground into a double play. Throats now here in the ninth inning for the U.S. Next up, Richards. And he too will ground out, and that will end the ball game. Kenta Uehara with a clean ninth inning. There you see him. And Japan wins this one 8-0. They will now play the winner of Korea Chinese Taipei in the gold medal game. For the first time at Universiade, handball will be competed. It has been held as a World University Championship since 1963, but now it's a Universiade sport. Serbia taking on Montenegro. Stanisav Lajovic with a jump shot there. It deflects in. Serbia in red, Montenegro in white. There's Esma Muradovic. A little bit off balance, but fires one home there through the Serbian goalkeeper Rizovic. Now a nice move by Janja Savic. She will open up the shooting lane and score. Here Pejovic makes a nice pass to Ramosovic for the goal. Montenegro staying tough against the strong Serbians. Now Radosav Lajovic in all alone, and she will tuck it home. Serbia now up 13-6. Another turnover there, and Radojevic is sent in all by herself. She makes no mistake. 16-8 now, Serbia in front. Here again is Stanisav Lajovic. And she, in the air, will readjust. Scores her second of the half. Now Jalkovic passes inside to Ramosovic. And Montenegro back now down 17-9. But again, Stanisavljevic, her third goal of the game, keeping Serbia's lead. There you saw Bursac making it 22-13, Serbia. Now Sanja Primović fires it high, and she will score. Now Janja Savic, a great pass given to her, and she will score, making the final 23-15 for Serbia over Montenegro. In their last preliminary game, Serbia takes on Japan and Montenegro, Ukraine. A busy night at the Gwangju Universiade main stadium. Athletics full on here tonight. First up, the women's 200 meter final. In lane three, Victoria Zyabkina of Kazakhstan. She won the 100 meter gold already here in Gwangju, looking to double her gold medal total. And coming off the turn, she will be in first place, trying to hold off Akelia Mitchell of the United States. And she will be able to do it. Zyabkina wins her second gold medal in a personal best time of 22.77 seconds. Mitchell also personal best, 22.95 seconds. And Kadisha Dallas of Jamaica wins bronze, a personal best for her as well. Now to the men's 200 meter final. There you see the start list. Kofi in lane five won bronze in the 100 meter final in Kazan and won double gold at the African Championships last year in Marrakesh in both the 100 and 200 meters. And there you see them off the turn. American Bryce Robinson, he fades though a little bit here, and Kofi comes on. Kofi wins gold just ahead of Bryce Robinson, who held on for silver. Ramil Guliev of Turkey wins bronze. Guliev actually won gold in Belgrade in 2009 when he competed for Azerbaijan. You'll see him there in third spot, but it will be Kofi, a season best 20.41 seconds, winning the gold medal. Now on to the women's 400 meter hurdles. There you have the starters. Lane six is Joanna Linkiewicz of Poland. She is third at this year's European Indoor Championship and also competed in Kazan. Christiane Klopps of Germany, she's in lane seven. She finished seventh in Kazan. Right now it's Linkiewicz ahead of Kramova of Russia, who is fading. You can see there, can she hold on for a medal? Linkiewicz securely in first for gold. Kramova will fade. And Ankovic will actually move into second spot, another pole, just ahead of Irina Tatuntheva of Russia, who will win the bronze medal. And there you see Linkiewicz, time of 56.62 seconds, just ahead of countrywoman Ankovic, who wins silver. Tatuntheva of Russia, the bronze. Now the men's turn at the 400 meter hurdles. In lane one, Amadou Ndiaye. He is here from Senegal, won silver in this event in 2013. In lane six, Ivan Chablyev of Russia. He was fifth in 400 meter hurdles in Kazan. And down the final straightaway, Thomas Barr looking to become the first Irish gold medalist since 1991, and he will do it. Sonia O'Sullivan in the 1500 meters in Sheffield, England, in 1991, the last Irish gold medalist. But there you see Barr, a huge smile on his face, a gold medalist here in Gwangju. Lau Lu of Algeria second, and Shabliev of Russia wins the bronze. Now to the women's 800 meter final. And Angela Petty in lane five, was fourth in Kazan, and was fifth at last year's Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, Scotland. And in lane six, Fabian Coleman of Germany, former European junior champion. Here you get a close-up of Petty. As they make their way around the final turn, Samoya Campbell of Jamaica in front. But Petty finding an extra gear. Will she have enough to pass Campbell? She does just there. And Angela Petty from New Zealand wins gold. Samoya Campbell holds on for silver. And Fabian Coleman of Germany wins a bronze medal. For Petty, that's a personal best, 1 minute 59.06 seconds. In fact, for Campbell, too, it's a personal best, 1 minute 59.26 seconds. So a quick race for these athletes, but that extra gear that Petty found enough to give her the gold. And there you see a huge smile on the face of the Kiwi, Angela Petty. Now to the men's high jump. There you see the finalists. First up from Slovakia, Matis Bubenik. He set a personal best of 2 meters 27 last year. And he will clear there at 2 meters 28. Next up, Xiang Chun Xian of Chinese Taipei. He's also trying at 2 meters 28. And he clears it quite easily, a personal best for him. So he matches the personal best set by Bubenik. Daniil Tsiplikov of Russia, he cleared at 2:28, now trying his third attempt at 2:31. This would give him a gold medal, as you can see him going through the mental preparation. And he does. Tsiplikov clears at 2:31. He will win the gold medal here in Guangzhou in the men's high jump. It kisses the camera for good measure. You get a good look there at that great jump by Tsiplikov. So it'll be Tsiplikov in first. Bubenik wins silver for Slovakia. And Xiang wins bronze from Chinese Taipei. Swimming action continues here on day seven. There's the Nambu University Aquatic Center. This will wrap up the indoor portion. There will be the 10 kilometer races on day eight. There you see the start list for the women's 50 meter freestyle. Holly Barrett in lane three won gold in the 50 meter backstroke and a bronze in the 50 meter butterfly already here in Guangzhou. You see the flurry of water as these athletes make their way to the wall. And in lane five, Rosalia Nazritanova of Russia wins the gold, just ahead of fellow Russian Elizaveta Bazarova. And Holly Barrett of Australia wins another medal here, this time a bronze in the women's 50 meter freestyle. Now the men's 50-meter freestyle. Yawen Tsirkin of Belarus in lane five. He already has three medals here in Guangzhou. And Henrique Martins de Souza of Brazil, he's in lane three. He's got two gold already here in Korea. Great look there at these athletes powering their way to the finish. Tsirkin and Martins de Souza going at it. Tsirkin just ahead of Martins de Souza in a time of 22.22 seconds. He wins his fourth medal of the games. Henrik Martens, he will win his third. And there you see the final standings for the men's 50 meter freestyle. Now the women's 50 meter breaststroke final. Fiona Doyle in lane eight. She won a bronze already here in Gwangju in the 100-meter breaststroke. She's actually already qualified for the 2016 Olympics representing Ireland. Good overhead look at these athletes in this sprint. Maria Liver of Ukraine in lane four has the lead right now as they get close to the wall, and she will touch first. Liver wins gold in a time of 30.73 seconds, just ahead of Doyle, who comes from lane eight to win the silver medal. We have a tie for the bronze. Martina Carrero of Italy and Emma Rainey of the United States in a time of 31.11 seconds. Now the women's 200 meter butterfly final. Haley Flickinger of the United States won gold in the 4x200 meter relay and a bronze in the 400 meter individual medley here already in Korea. And Zhu Yilin of China has a silver from the 4x200 meter relay. And right now it is Zhu, just ahead of Alicia Polieri of Italy. She will touch first, winning gold in a time of 2 minutes, 7.69 seconds, 97 one-hundredths ahead of Polieri, who will win the silver. Haley Flickinger wins her third medal of these games, this time a bronze in the women's 200-meter butterfly. And the final event we'll look at tonight, the women's 800-meter freestyle. This features Martina Caramignoli of Italy. She won a gold in the 1500 meters. And also Martina De Mem of Italy. She's in lane five. She won a bronze in the 200 meter and 400 meter freestyle here so far. So there you see in lane two, Lindsay Vrooman. Two silvers already in the 400 free and 1500 free. She now adds a gold to that collection. Caramignoli will finish second. And Kia Melverton of Australia, who won a bronze in the 1500 meter freestyle, she wins another bronze here in the 800. Vrooman in a time of 8 minutes, 26.67 seconds to take the gold just ahead of Caramignoli. There you get a close-up of Lindsay Vrooman. Caramignoli 1.76 seconds back. Melverton 5.13 seconds behind the top spot held there by Lindsay Vrooman. Table tennis action here on day seven. It's the women's team gold medal final between Chinese Taipei and China. And there you see the five potential matchups to take place. It's a best of five. This is the first match between Cheng Yicheng of Chinese Taipei and Zhuang Yue of China. Right now, 10-8 in favor of Cheng. And she will score there to win this first match for Chinese Taipei. China would take the second match, 3-0. And now we're looking at warm up here for the third match between Li Yichen of Chinese Taipei and Guo Yichen of China. This is the fifth game. 10-5 right now, Guo leading. She is in the far court. Lots of slices here right now from Guo. And in that case, they do not succeed. Li stays alive. And there's a miss by Li. And that will give Guo the win, 3-2. China now with a 2-1 lead over Chinese Taipei. So now getting ready for the fourth match. And this features Cheng Yiqing of Chinese Taipei and Che Zhaoji of China. Che would win the first two games, 11-9 and 11-9. The third game went to Cheng, 11-6. We're now tied up at 10 here in the fourth game. Cheng needing to win this one to keep Chinese Taipei alive here in this gold medal contest. And that one goes long. 11-10 now, Chinese Taipei in front. There's a serve from Cheng. And that one into the net. We're tied at two, heading to a fifth game. And there you see Chinese Taipei's coach talking it over with Cheng. 6-2 right now, Che in front. And a good rally there. And a good backhand by Che, now 7-2. And there a booming forehand by her. She's taken a commanding lead, 8-2 here in this fifth game. That one off the top of the net. And then returned long by Cheng, 9-3 now. Great rally here, some huge forehands, and Cheng's return falls short. China now 1 point away from gold, and there it is. Gold medal for China in women's team table tennis. They defeat Chinese Taipei 3-1. The bronze medals go to Japan and Korea.